All right. So this is a continuation of the earlier presentation which Gitika presented for the validation rules. So we had a look at how can we use validation rules in different scenarios, and also saw how we can use the data quality app and the validation rule analysis function to kind of generate a list of the validation rules which have been broken or which do not qualify the conditions that we have defined while creating a validation rules. So today we focus more on the use aspect. Tomorrow there are sessions which are dedicated to the design of these rules. So we'll focus more on the configuration tomorrow. And if time allows, we can also cover the predictors and the repetition of the concepts around how we can create predictors and use them for both data quality and threshold calculation. So coming back to notifications, basically you want to communicate the responses which the validation rule analysis app generates with a wider user group so that the people could take responses against the errors which have been identified in the data when you had run the validation rule analysis. So basically through the validation rule notifications, you are able to create a response, a message in response to a validation rule which has been violated. Okay. So these notifications can be sent out to the users. And when are you creating when you're creating your validation rule notifications, you can define that for which validation rule you want to trigger a notification. Who are your target audiences? Who are your recipients? And what message you want to send with respect to that violation? So I'll quickly show you a validation rule notification, how it has been created. The prerequisite is that for creating a notification, you must create a validation rule first because your notification is tied to the validation rule which you have created. Okay. So there are two ways in which these notifications can be sent out. One is when you do a manual validation analysis using the validation rule analysis function we just saw in the last couple of sessions. So when you are running the validation rule analysis, you have a checkbox there, which kind of asks you that whether you want to send notifications or not. If you check that checkbox, the system will not only run the validation rule analysis, but if any errors are spotted, then those errors would be sent as a part of the notification also. And secondly, you can create an automatic scheduling process. So there's an app called Scheduler in DHIS2 where you can schedule that every day at this point of time, you want to run the validation analysis and send the notifications to the users. So you can automate this process or you can also do a manual push of the notifications depending upon how you want to use the functionality to send the notifications. Now these notifications can be sent in three ways. One is you could utilize the DHIS2 internal messaging system. So we have a messages app where the users can communicate with each other one-to-one private messages, or they can contact an entire user group and share their messages. So through the messaging app, you could get access to these notifications which are getting generated from the validation rule analysis. Or if you want to use this information or share this information outside of DHIS2, then you can also send these notifications on through an email or an SMS as well. But for email and SMS to work, we need to configure an email server in the email settings in DHIS2, and a third-party SMS gateway has to be configured so that these notifications could be sent outside of DHIS2 through other means of communication. So all three are possible. The DHIS2 internal messaging system is available by default. It does not need any external development to be done. But if you are talking about the emails and the SMS, then they need to be sent through an email server or an SMS gateway, which have to be configured on top of the DHIS2 system. Now, in the previous slide, I mentioned about the notifications, which can have dynamic parameters in the message itself. Okay, So we talked about that when we are creating a notification, we need to select a rule that this rule, when this rule gets violated, send this notification. But when you are creating a notification, you're creating a message body, basically. So in that message body, you have some dynamic parameters which you can pre-select, and the system will fill those information and send the rules accordingly. Okay. So for example, you want to send the clinic where the rule has been violated, the period for when for which the data has been reported, and the descriptions, the name of the rule, and the priority. So these are certain variables which are available for configuration. So you can select the rules for which you want to send notifications and what do you want to send in notification. So we can define the content of the notification through these dynamic parameters. So in the example that we will see, a validation rule notification, which has been already pre-configured, we can see what parameters we use in terms of creating that notification in the system. So basically the prime focus here is for creating this notification is to allow user to identify and respond to the challenges with the data quality checks, which have been already done by the supervisor or by the program manager. So if you receive a notification which through the validation rules, then it means that you have to quickly see that what challenges has the system identified with the data, and what should be really corrected by looking at the descriptions which are available as part of the validation rule construct that we do. So the idea here is that notifications should be kept to a bare minimum rules which are of high priority, because if we send anything in bulk, people kind of lose focus on that. So it's kind of our call within our implementations that for what rules do we want to really send out notifications. So any data which is of high priority, which should be reported with utmost correction, then for those selected data elements, we should create the validation rules and we should add them to the notifications. So the lesser the number of notifications you decide, the kind of focus is there that these are the quintessential data points which need to have correct data. So you can create validation rules as many as you want, but for notifications, the best practice is that keep the notifications to a minimum and you send it out to the right people. Or else if you just keep getting notifications from the entire data sets which you have in the system, then they kind of lose value and people tend to ignore them over time. So that's the thing where you kind of do's and don'ts of using notifications. So this was my last slide. I'll jump on to the demonstration now and I'll take you through one of the notifications that we have created, and then we can see how these notifications reach out in our different ways. So just give me a sec, I'll share my system screen. All right, so here you see in the maintenance app, you have an option to add validation rule, a validation group, and a validation notification. Okay. So tomorrow we'll focus on creating the actual rules, what are the mechanisms in which we can create a rule and how predictors can support validation rules. Today we'll focus more on the notification aspect. So now we have a notification which is already created, which kind of will send out an alert to the health facility and the users who are associated to the health facility to check the data in case the rotavirus 2 doses which have been administered are less than or equal to the rotavirus 2 threshold. Okay. So if you, I'll just quickly edit this. So what you've done here is we've given the notification a name, and then we've selected the validation rule here that in case the doses administered are greater than the rotavirus threshold, then you're supposed to send a notification to the facility and its users. Okay. So it's important that when you're creating a notification, you must have a validation rule created in advance. Okay. So you create a validation rule and then you associate that validation rule with a notification. So here I've selected that I would like to send a notification for this particular validation rule. Now, this is to whom the messages should go or to whom the validation rule notification should be shared with. Okay? So then you can define user groups in DHIS. So when you're creating users, you can tag certain users to a particular group. So if the immunization group is responsible for the data quality and the data entry and the data management for the EPI program. So we can create a group for immunization notification. So all those users which are part of this immunization notification group, only they will receive the SMS or the alert for the validation notification, because the data that we're talking about here belongs to the EPI or the immunization program. So you're kind of defining that what validation rule should have a notification and to which set of users these notifications should go. And then how do you want to send these notifications as? So for example, when I'm running my validation rule analysis at the district level, I might get information for 10 different health facilities. Okay. So now it's my choice that whether I want to send one notification per facility, or I want to send a collective summary, which will kind of summarize the alerts for all the health facilities in that respective district. Or if I'm looking at the validation rule analysis for more than one health facility. So collective summaries are better because they kind of group the information together and will show you in one snapshot rather than clicking on individual messages for each value. So, but the call is yours. You can select both the options, the collective summary or the single notifications. Then there's an option to notify users in the hierarchy only. Okay. So now if I'm working in one respective district, and if I check this option, then this notification will only send messages to the health facilities who are under that respective district. So this way you're kind of blocking your or making your target audience much the scope much more less or much less wider in terms of that this notification should only be sent to the people who are part of the hierarchy. So if I am the district manager for immunization and I want to send this notification out, then it will only send the notification to the users who are kind of below or the facilities which are below my district. So it will not send it to any other users, it will only send to. So district A has 10 facilities, then this notification will go to only 10 facilities and not to the other districts. Okay. So by this, you can restrict in terms of your spread of geography, in terms of the spread of health facilities in that district, to what all areas or to what all health facilities should this notification go out. So now you create your messaging template. So this would be the subject of the notification when it goes out, that rotavirus 2 doses given exceeds the calculated threshold. And this is the message template which you can create. So I spoke of dynamic parameters being available in my presentation. So if you see here, you have these template variables which you can use to create your message. And wherever you use these template, these variables, the system will automatically push the values from the validation rule result and send this as a message. Okay. So I've added that the number of rotavirus values, and it should pick the left side value because I've given the expression of left side value here should be less than equal to rotavirus to threshold. Then I've given the variable for picking up the right side value in this health facility during this period. So I have created a template of a message, and you could add on more variables also if you want. Okay. So this message right now gives me the crux of the information that I need that for rotavirus 2 doses, this is the value which has been entered, and for the threshold, this is the value which is available, which we calculated through the predictors. And this is the facility where there is an issue with the data and for which month. Okay. So these variables are kind of enough for me to understand the issue and to go and fix it. Okay. But if you think you need any more information, then you have these variables available to add more variables and make your subject more descriptive if you want. Okay. So this is how you create your validation notification. So for each validation rule, you can create one notification. And it is suggested that you create a validation rule notification only for those validation rules which are of higher priority, so that the focus remains intact when you're sending out these notifications. Okay. Now we spoke of how we can run these notifications. So if you go to the data quality app here, we have already used the validation rule analysis application. Okay, so what you can do is you can select your organization unit. For example, you want to see for you want to do a data quality check against the immunization threshold for the animal region. You can select a period. So I'll just select March 1. And I'll just select my immunization thresholds. Okay. Now I have send notifications as the checkbox here. So if I want to push these notifications manually, then I can click on send notifications and click on validate. So there are no validation violations available for this period. So let's select something else. Okay, so we have some rules which got violated. And there are values available for these respective health facilities for this respective period. Now, if you look on the top on the messages app, you have some messages which have been sent to your inboxes. So if you see these, then these are the validation messages that have been sent because I was sending notifications through the validation rules. Okay. So now, all those members who are already part of this validation rule notification group. So there's a user group we created for immunization notifications, and we added you as a member so that you could also see these notifications. So now, since we had selected a collective summary, so you get the information for each of the health facility. And since you have access to the entire hierarchy, the training land, so you get the collective summary of all the health facilities, all the periods for which we had checked the rule, the data for that respective validation rule. So if you see here, so this kind of is coming through your template that we had created. Okay, so let's for 7. So then these values are then autofilled. So 70 was your left-hand side value and 0 was your right-hand side value. And then this particular is your health facility, your dispensary, and this is your period, October 2019. So these variables were pre-filled by the system and the values were pre-filled by the system. And then a collective summary was sent to you for all the health facilities where you see that this validation rule has been violated and you have a response against that specific situation. Okay. So this is the whole concept of how the validation rule function in the HRS2, the notifications. If there's any question, please feel free to ask, or you can also post on Slack and we could answer them. There's an exercise available where you're supposed to repeat the same steps which I just demonstrated. You need to run the validation rule notification and see if you get the messages in the messaging app in the validation tab, so you can see the messages as collective summaries. So any questions, please let me know. I'll just quickly see if there are any questions on the Zoom chat, and I'll try to respond.